हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर वंदना काले फ्रॉम इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ AISSMS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी पुणे. इन दिस सेशन वी विल सी द सर्किट डायग्राम एंड डेरिवेशन ऑफ V2I कन्वर्टर सर्किट विथ जीरो एंड स्पैन एडजस्टमेंट एंड द सर्किट इज डिजाइंड यूजिंग ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर. The circuit diagram for V2I converter using operational amplifier is shown in the figure. The circuit consists of the input signal V1 that is given to non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. The circuit consists of load resistor RL that is connected in between inverting terminal and output terminal of op-amp IC. As neither end of load resistor is connected to ground, that's why the load is called as floating load. Also, the circuit consists of one more resistor R that is connected in between inverting input terminal of op-amp and ground. In the last lecture, we come across the final current equation, that is I is equal to V1 divided by R. So this circuit produces output current I, which is given by the input signal voltage V1 divided by the resistor R. So from this equation we can say output current I is directly proportional to the input voltage V1, and this is the linear equation. So this V2I converter circuit is also a linear application of op-amp. If we see this linear equation, it can be represented by a transfer function which is just straight line. So here we can say this dark blue color straight line, it is the transfer function of V2I converter circuit. The generalized equation for the straight line is given by y is equal to mx plus c, where the variable m, it decides slope of the straight line. So if we change the value of m, the slope of the straight line it changes, and here we can see with the help of these dotted lines, if the slope gets double and if the slope gets half, how the original straight line changes with the change in slope. This factor m, it is also called as span adjustment variable. In this equation, the variable c is called as y intercept. In the second figure we can see, if we change the value of the c, the intersection point of the straight line on the I axis, it changes. So c variable, it is called as zero adjustment variable. If the value of c changes, then the interception of or the crossing point of the straight line, it changes. So y is equal to mx plus c, it is the generalized equation of the straight line. in case of V2I converter circuit, we obtained the output current equation as I is equal to V1 divided by R. So if we compare this output current equation with the standard equation of the straight line, then we can say I is the output variable, V1 is the input variable, 1 divided by R, it is the slope deciding parameter. So if we want to change the slope of the straight line, then it is possible by changing the value of resistor R. In this equation, we can see there is no C parameter available. It means with the help of the earlier circuit, we cannot achieve zero adjustment. We can achieve only span adjustment. However, if we want zero and span adjustment with V2I converter, we can achieve it with the help of some components by adding those components in the V2I circuit. So here, this is the circuit diagram for V2I converter with zero and span adjustment. If we look at this circuit diagram, we can see it is having two resistors of value 1k and one voltage source V reference as the additional component as compared to the V2I converter circuit. So here, suppose we remove this additional network, then the circuit will be same as that of the earlier circuit of V2I converter, where we get output current I is equal to V1 divided by R. Now, so as to achieve zero and span adjustment, we have introduced here this additional circuitry. Now we will calculate the voltage V1 in terms of Vin and V reference, so that we can put that value of V1 in the current equation. So to find out the voltage V1, we will use superposition theorem and voltage divider rule. Initially, we will consider V reference is absent, that means this terminal is grounded and only V in is present, and we will calculate V1 as 1 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by 1 into 10 raised to power 3 plus 1 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by V in. In the second case, we will consider V in is absent, that is this terminal is grounded and only V reference is present, and we will get the second term. So here we have used superposition theorem. If we simplify this equation, we get V1 as 1 divided by 2 in bracket V in plus V reference. Now we will put this V1 in the current equation, that is I is equal to V1 divided by R, and we can get the modified current equation as output current I is equal to 1 divided by 2R V in plus 1 divided by 2R V reference. Now this is the output current equation that we obtained with this additional circuitry. Now we will compare this output current with the generalized equation of a straight line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. So if we compare these two equations, here we can say m is having value 1 divided by 2r, which is span adjusting variable. So if we vary the value of resistor r, we can vary the span of the straight line. Again here we can see c is equal to 1 divided by 2r into v reference, which is zero adjusting variable. So by varying the resistor r and or v reference, we can vary the crossing point of the straight line on the vertical axis. So here, with the help of these two additional resistors of 1 kilo ohm and one voltage source V reference, we can achieve span and zero adjustment in the circuit of V2I converter. Thank you.